Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to use Gemini AI API with JavaScript Node.js. So let's get started. So first thing is we need to get the API key. Without only we will be able to access Gemini AI's API. So for this, just Google Gemini AI API. You'll be getting this link, which is ai.google.dev. This link over here, we'll be getting this interface. And you need to sign in with your Google account. You'll be having here sign in option. You need to sign in with that. After this, just click on get API key in Google AI Studio. You'll be getting an interface like this. We have two models over here. One is Gemini Pro and another one is Gemini Pro Vision. With Vision, we can send images also as input. But for this example, we are just going to use Gemini Pro. And we are having a space where you can test our input. So for example, essay on AI. And if I just hit run, this will give us the response. So this is just like a playground where we can give our input and get the response from Gemini AI model. This is the response that I get from Gemini Pro model. So now let's see how we can write our own JavaScript code and get the response. So for doing this, it's so simple. We just need to copy and paste from their documentation. So to the left, here you can see we will be having a documentation. Just click this. And leftmost side, you'll be having for Node.js. Again, click here. And if you just scroll down, and basically this is the code that we are going to use. So let me just copy this code and go to my Visual Studio code and let me just create a JavaScript file and paste the code over here. So this is the code that we got from the documentation. And the only thing that we need to add here is the API key. So for doing that, again, go to the studio and here we will be having option to get API key. Just click this and this is fine. I don't care. Just click on OK. So here for creating API key, we need to just click on create API key. Just click this. And it will give you two options, create an API key in a new project if you don't have already one, or else you can just search your existing cloud projects. I don't have anything, so I will just click on create API key in new project. So this is the API key, do not share them, okay, to anyone. I'll just copy this and I'll just go to the code and here I'm just going to replace. I'm not going to have this env file or something like that. I'm just going to replace this with the API key within double quotes. Okay, this is what I'm going to do over here. And the next thing is we need to have this particular npm library. Okay, we need to have this Google generative AI. So if you Google this, you'll be getting the npm package. So this is the one, Google AI JavaScript SDK. So we'll be having the use case. So they're also having a sample code. You can even like copy and paste for a Gemini Pro Vision over here in case if you want to try Gemini Pro Vision there. So we just need to run this command. So I'll just copy this and go to my terminal, paste it. This is the generative AI object. And with that, we are passing the model name, which is Gemini Pro. And we are giving a prompt over here and we're getting the response. And this is just the text form of our response. So it's quite a simple code, just a few lines. So I'll just go with same thing, essay on AI. And the response is getting console logged. So we don't need to do anything. So for running this, it's going to be node space file name dot js. Here you can see this is the response that I get about essay on AI. So now let's just see what is the entire response. Okay, so I'll just remove this and I will just replace this with just this variable. Okay, the result that we are getting. Okay, or maybe I will also like print the result. Okay, this is the one and we are filtering response from this. So I'll just copy this also, paste it. This is going to be result. Saving it and just rerun it again. This is the JSON that we get. The first one corresponds to result. So this is the result thing. So we're getting an object and second one corresponds to the response. So this is the response. Inside response, we're having candidates, prompt, feedback and text. Same thing, candidates, prompt, feedback and text. So this is like a function, anonymous. So that's the reason why we are, you know, we had here response dot text. So the final thing that I wanted to show you is how you can minimize the response that you get, because here you can see we got literally four big paragraphs. So for doing that, just scroll down in the same website. here you'll be having something called as max tokens, which is also called as configure model parameters. So we will be passing these values along with our model name. So if you want to learn more about this, what each and everything means, you can just click on this model parameters and learn about that each and everything. They explain what are the parameters that they are passing along with the model. But our main focus is max output tokens. So by specifying a number, we can limit the response text that we are getting. So I'll just copy this entire thing, go to my code, to the function, because they are just calling a function over here. So the top of the function, pasting it and copying the variable, and they have put the variable along with the model name. So I will just go here, the model is here, just put a comma and paste the variable name. Okay, I think now we are good, and just rerun the code. So here you can see, this time I'm having the output tokens as 200, and earlier I think you would be remembering we got like 4 to 5 paragraphs, but this time we are getting only 2 paragraphs. So that's because of this max output tokens. And that's the video, guys. This is how we use Gemini's API along with JavaScript Node.js. I hope you'd have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in programming, AI, and other OpenAI tutorials also. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.